everybody.
Good morning.
Let's try that one more time. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
It's great to have you in church today. We had about 65 in the first service, had about 100 here for Sunday school, which was great. And I'm so glad that you're with us today in worship. It's a beautiful morning. What a beautiful day God's given to us. And the rain we got yesterday was so nice. And, you know, God is so good to us. And we have so much to be thankful for. Charles and Autumn, it's good to have you all here with us today. We're online. This may be the last time we're online for a little while. So all you folks that are watching online, we're going to be trying to figure out a new way to do this. I do want to mention that if you have your bulletin, that the WOM is having their general meeting on Tuesday night, September 1st, and Wednesday will be the youth gathering, and the youth will be meeting with Cole Lane at 6 o'clock. So all you young people, spread the word, 6 o'clock, and then we'll be having a prayer service here. As you know, today is Kyle and Shanti's last Sunday with us. There is a beautiful card basket back there. Hopefully you brought a card to put in the plate for them. If you have appreciated and enjoyed Kyle and Shanti, let's give them a hand. They've been a great blessing. And just know that you go to Eureka with our love. Kyle, you're right there together. Bang, bang. And with our love, and we'll be praying that God will bless you in this move, and that all will go extremely well. God bless you. I have a couple of prayer requests that I want to mention to you. Right now, I have a niece that is getting ready to go into surgery in Wichita, Kansas. Her name is Camellia. It's my younger brother's daughter, and they're going to do an emergency C-section. She's had problems with the pregnancy all the way through, and she's been staying at the hospital for the last 2 weeks because of bleeding issues. And so I appreciate when we pray in just a moment, if you'll remember Camellia in your prayers. And hopefully I'll hear something pretty much later today about that. She's not due for another month. So pray for Camellia. Also, I want us to pray for John Maples and Cecil Cott and Irene Sims and others within our church family. So let's go to the Word of God. Go to the Lord. Yes, Arlene. Okay. And also, you mentioned JT. Oh, CT. And let's be in prayer for him as well. He lives in Sedalia. And this is your brother-in-law. Okay, so let's remember him in our prayers as well. Anybody else have a prayer need or a prayer request? Be happy to take that. Okay, if not, let's go to the Lord in a word of prayer, and then we're going to watch a little video presentation. Heavenly Father, we just thank you that we can gather together on this Sunday and worship you. We pray, God, that our worship will be true and in spirit and in truth. We pray that your Holy Spirit will guide us as we sing today, as we open your word and rightly divide the word of truth. We pray, Father, for all of these many prayer requests. We pray especially for Camellia as she is undergoing surgery right now. We pray, God, that you will watch over her and the little baby. And we just ask you to be the great physician. Be with CT as well and Earlene's family, Arlene's family, and just provide for them. Be with John and Mary and Cecil and Barbara and Irene and all those that we love so much. Bless this worship service, and may you find great joy in our praise and worship, because it's all about you, Lord. We pray it in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's watch this video clip.
Hello, ladies. My name is Christy McClellan. He's doing it for us. We look back and read these stories that we might learn to take heart as daughters in our own day, in our own generation, right here, right now. So if you need to be lifted up, if you need to be restored, if you need to be brought out of your shame, given back your honor, and compelled to live forward in your own life in peace and shalom, join us for Jesus and Women in the First Century Now.
It is a beautiful day to be in the house of the Lord. I'm glad you've all joined us this morning. I appreciate all the prayers I had. I did have surgery on my neck, and it was very successful, out of pain. And I just had to wear this to keep me from swinging my head around so much. They didn't want me to get too carried away up here. Brother Michael sneezed, and he thought I was up here to preach since I had my collar on. But I told him by the time we got down up here, I was a little hot under the collar. But it is good to see you all. I always enjoy coming to church and seeing everybody in person. Seeing your smiling faces, even if we're not shaking hands so much and hugging, that kind of thing right now. But I want to ask you to stand as we get started here. Shout to the Lord.